Thank you. Good morning to all. Thanks for coming out this morning. Great to see so many people out here. On what started as a typical Tuesday with the hustle of everyday life, a beautiful late summer morning on September 11, 2001, became a day of death, destruction, and uncertainty. Four American domestic jet airliners were taken over by Islamic terrorist group Al-Qaeda and used as weapons to inflict mass casualties and coordinated attacks against our United States on selected targets. These intended targets we will forever know, and of course, we'll never forget. These despicable, heinous acts of aggression that took place on our soil was the likes of what we have never seen. Indelibly etched in the minds of those who witnessed the horror of that day is the jets that were being deliberately flown into the iconic towers of the World Trade Center, the gaping, smoking hole of the west wall of our Pentagon, and the scarred field in Shanksville, Pennsylvania. When the sun set on this fateful day, we would realize thousands of people were killed or injured. And in the eventual days of months and years to come, the aftermath, more deaths would also occur. It goes without saying, our lives would be forever changed from these horrific acts. To our nation, and not only our nation, but the world, we now live in a very different place post 9/11. As the attack on Pearl Harbor by the Japanese shocked our nation December 7, 1941, so did this momentous event. Once again, we as a nation united to defend our freedom and our way of life and serve justice to those who have such disdain for our country. Being gathered here today, we know the commitment it requires to ensure peace and stability. Freedom is a precious commodity, and it's only guaranteed by those who are willing to carry the torch after it has been handed off by the previous generation. We have such men and women who serve our communities, our states, and nation, those who run the danger rather than from it, either serving in the armed forces or in law enforcement, or as fire personnel, emergency medical personnel, or first responders, giving selflessly for their benefit and for all of humanity. In the past 18 years, many lives have been lost to defend and protect our freedom, and others who have to bear with the struggles of their mental and physical disabilities from their duty as performing to protect our freedom and our nation. Yes, the price of freedom is an unpayable debt, and we can never repay that. Enjoy your freedom and be forever thankful to those who carry that torch. God bless you all. God bless America.